Hey, this is Jay with Sacred Gaming bringing you some House of Wolves info. With the patch that came out Friday, we now have the ability to join the Great Wolf Hunt and avenge the Awoken. So what you want to do is go to the tower. Petra is back here. This is normally in the area that's closed off. You have the Iron Banner guy that is usually to the right. And then Petra is all the way back here where she was before when she was here. But you're going to go back here, talk to the Queen's Emissary, and then you can actually pick up 5 bounties today if you didn't do these 4 yesterday. These 4 were opened yesterday on Friday, and then today I saw that the 5th one is opened up, and I'm assuming probably the 6th one will be opened up tomorrow or Monday. So what you want to do is look for that bottom left-hand corner that says a pack of wolves is prowling. That is an indicator that the event is happening in the particular areas, and if you read the bounty descriptions, it tells you what areas to go to. There's 2 on Earth and 2 on Venus that you can do. So once you do that, you just want to wait and look for the drop ship. These guys will be dropped off, and then you just want to take them out. There's going to be several waves that you're going to have to go through. I'll tell you how to do this. I'm actually doing this one solo, so it is possible to do solo. It is very hard. You really want to pick up some friends if you can, but you can do it if you need to solo. So after you kill this first wave, you're going to get these rocket launchers that actually drop right here. And I'm not going to actually pick those up. They are called Scorch Cannons, though. Now, I was doing this one time with a couple of friends, and we didn't pick up the Scorch Cannons, and they ended up disappearing. So you might want to be careful. You can pick them up. You can drop them and then re-pick them up and everything like that. But for some reason, they didn't disappear on me when I was doing this solo. But I'm not going to guarantee that, but you want to try this out, because the first few waves are pretty easy, and I wanted to save these for the final wave. Now, you're going to get tons of heavy ammo that drops during you doing these, so you don't have to worry about using any heavy ammo cakes or anything like that. But if you can save those Scorch Cannons, I think it's going to really help you with the final boss. Now, as far as classes and what to run, you definitely want to bring with some arc damage weapons, because a lot of these captain guys and everything else, they have arc shields. And I didn't even bring my G-Horn. In fact, I'm running the Fatebringer, a arc damage shotgun, which I think is just critical for doing this. And then also, I'm running the Song of Ur-Yut, which is a legendary heavy weapon. It's a machine gun that does arc damage. So that's what I'd recommend doing that. A Striker Titan is really nice too, because it does arc damage as well. But as you can see, you know, it's not going to be that hard these first few waves. And I decided to pick one of these up just to go through these a little bit faster. But this Scorch Cannon is pretty fun. You get 10 rounds for it. You cannot get any more heavy ammo though, like by running over packs and everything like that. But it will do short work of these guys, and I still have 2 left to kind of hold off. Now, if you're doing this with a bunch of people, probably everybody's going to grab one of these right away and just go to town with them, so you won't be able to save them. But when you're doing them by yourself, you're probably going to have a few. But you might want to coordinate that, especially if you do have other people that you're playing with on your friends list that you can communicate. Maybe the guys who pick up the Scorch Cannon take out the captains and the yellow bar guys, and then everybody else just shoots the little guys and maybe save one of them for later stages. I don't know. You can figure some really good strategies out, I'm sure. Now, I should say this. Do not shoot the guys when they get out of the ship. You know how everybody loves to, when they actually peek out of the ship before they jump down, you shoot them with a rocket launcher? Don't do that. They're immune right now, so it won't help out. Now, you also notice too, this event starts. A lot of times you will get events that kind of happen at the same time. You just have to ignore them if they're gonna, you know, get in the way. I think the Fallen Walker ended up doing this right after this. But this is the final guy. He is a stealth captain for this particular area. I shot him a bunch of times with that Scorch Cannon, then picked up another one. If you're doing this without Scorch Cannons, it is really helpful to actually shoot this guy with like a light machine gun or your arc damage primary, and then switch to an arc damage shotgun and take him out. Then when you have to reload everything and start the whole process over again, because his shield goes back super fast. Now, as soon as you get that done though, there's going to be a chest that randomly spawns in different areas, and this chest has the potential of giving you some really nice stuff. Now, after you actually pick up the items from this chest, you can actually leave the area. Just drive out of here if you find it really fast. Drive out of here, wait till you get an indicator that says you're in a different area of the map, and then drive straight back, and you can hit that and you can get a second drop there. So keep that in mind just in case you find that really fast. It is hard to find sometimes, but you will notice that yellow light that actually goes up from there. So as soon as you get it done, maybe split up with everybody go in different directions, and then when you find it, make sure you point to it. Now, when you do get items out of this chest, they will tell you that you should go to the Cryptarch, or you'll get this little indicator to go to the Cryptarch, but when you do that, they will not show up, and they're not going to show up until Tuesday. So just hang on to any engrams that you get. And you can get blue engrams, you can get purple engrams, and you can also get Prison of Elder keys, and there might be some other things. I didn't get anything but blue engrams. I did pick up one purple engram, but it wasn't from the chest, so I was able to turn that in. I will say this, hang on to your purple engrams. Do not turn them in, because I just got shards from them. And after Tuesday, you won't have to worry about that. But I think that's where I'm going to end this video. I'll show you what happens when you turn in the first four bounties. You're going to end up hitting Queen's Rank 1 if you have the Nightfall done and you get that extra XP for doing that. I don't know if you can quite reach that if you don't, but check out how I finished off this spider tank with the Titan Smash. You got to love that. But as I said, you can do the first four after you get those done. I went and checked today. You cannot redo those again. You can stay in the areas though and keep killing these people and trying to get something cool for the chest, but as far as the bounties goes, you finish them and you're done, and that might get reset on Tuesday. I'm sure that probably will. But there you go. If you got any questions or comments, make sure you leave them for me. If you got anything cool from the chest, make sure you leave them in the comments section. But guys, as always, take care and God bless.